Hello there and welcome to the October 2020 paper 1. Here we're looking at question 6, 2-6 markers of proof by induction. Yippee! So, prove by induction that for n existing in the positive integers, this expression on the left is equal to this expression on the right. This one doesn't look too bad. So, part 1 is prove for n equals 1. So, the left-hand side is going to equal the summation from 1 up to 1 of 3r plus 1, r plus 2, and let's substitute that in then, so it's going to be 1 times 3 is 3 plus 1 is 4 times 3, which equals 12. Hopefully it'll equal 12 on the right hand side as well. The right hand side, when we substitute 1 in, is going to give us 1 times 3 times 4, which is equal to 12 as well. Good, so therefore the left-hand side equals the right-hand side, so this is true. Good, part 2 is now assume true. Assume theorem true for n equals k. So that's saying that if you want to add up the first k numbers of this expression here, 3r plus 1r plus 2, then you can use this formula on the right hand side, which for k is going to be k plus 2, k plus 3. Okay, so we can assume our theorem works up to k. Now what we're going to do is we're going to prove true for n equals k plus 1. So what we want to show, WTS, always start off part 3 with a WTS, is that our theorem, if we sum up to k plus 1, is going to equal of this 3r plus 1, r plus 2, we're going to get an answer of k plus 1, k plus 3, k plus 4. Because what I've done there is just set n equal to n plus 1 on both sides. So that's what we want to show, so let's show it then. So starting off with the left-hand side, this summation is going to equal, so if we substitute 1 in, then that's going to give us 4 times 3. So it's going to start with 4 times 3. Then if we substitute 2 in, then that's going to give us 7 times 4. The next one's going to be 10 times 5. The next one's going to be 13 times 6. And that will carry on dot 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 all the way up to the kth term. So that's going to be 3k plus 1, k plus 2, and then the k plus 1th term as well. So that's going to be 3k plus 4. K plus 3. So I've gone all the way up to, from substituting in 1, substituting 2, substituting in 3, substituting in 4, all the way up to substituting in k and substituting in k plus 1. Now what we know is this theorem here. We can use this theorem here to simplify a lot of this summation here. We can use this formula to simplify all the summation up to k being substituted in. We've got this extra bit on the end, which is k plus 1 substituted in. So let's use the formula in the first box here to simplify the first k term substituted into that formula. So it's going to be k plus 2, and k plus 3. Add then k plus 1 substituted in, which is kind of like the extra bit in this summation. So it's 3k plus 4, k plus 3. Now what I've seen so far is that k plus 3 is a common factor between both the terms. And then let's expand the brackets on the rest of it. K squared plus 2k. And then on the second bit is going to be 3k plus 4. Let's now simplify that expression there, k plus 3. And the second bit here is going to be k squared plus 5k plus 4. So then if we factorise that, that's going to be k plus 1, k plus 4. And then we'll just write it in the correct order for the right-hand side. So it's going to be equals k plus 1, k plus 3, and k plus 4. So there we are, that's the answer for this third part here. We've shown that this now equals the right-hand side. And you can clearly see the structure of this proof. Left-hand side equals, 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 equals the right-hand side. So the left-hand side equals the right-hand side. And now part 4. I'm not going to write out all of part 4 because my pen's a bit glitchy today. But the conclusion goes, as we have proven true for n equals 1, and as our theorem works for the value n equals k, we have proven that our theorem is true for n equals k plus 1. Therefore, by induction, this theorem is true for just the set of n values that exist in positive integers. So it's just true for that set of values for n there. Make sure you include that little bit there. I had one student a couple of years ago who lost a mark because they didn't include that their theorem only works for this set of values for n. Okay, so that's the answer for part A. Let's now move on to part B. Okay, part B is prove by induction that for all odd positive integers n, f of n equals 4 to the power of n plus 5 to the power of n plus 6 to the power of n is divisible by 15. Okay, let's get started then. Again, it's still proving true for n equals 1 because that's an odd integer as well. So for n equals 1, f of 1 equals 4 plus 5 plus 6 equals 15, which is divisible by 15, which is divisible by 15. Good, moving on to part 2 now. So assume theorem true for an odd value k. So therefore f of k equals 4 to the power of k plus 5 to the power of k plus 6 to the power of k is divisible by 15. Okay, now what we want to show is that the next odd number, now what's the next odd number going to be? If k is an odd number, then the next odd number is going to be k plus 2. So now we want to prove true for n equals k plus 2. You don't need to do any of this 2k plus 1 malark. All you have to do is prove that it works the next number up in our theorem, which is the next odd number up, which is 2 on from where we currently are. So what we want to show is that f of k plus 2 equals 4 to the power of k plus 2 plus 5 to the power of k plus 2 plus 6 to the power of k plus 2 is divisible by 15, is divisible by 15. Right, okay, so let's get started on this then. This is what we want to show. Let's put it in a box so we've got it highlighted. So, f of k plus 2 equals 4 to the power of k plus 2, add 5 to the power of k plus 2, add 6 to the power of k plus 2. Now what I'm going to do with all of these, because at some point I'm going to have to bring in my assumption step, I'm going to reduce all the powers on this just down to k. So I'm going to split this up into 4 to the power of k times 4 to the power of 2 plus 5 to the power of k times 5 to the power of 2 plus 6 to the power of k times 6 to the power of 2. Okay, so what I've done is reduced all the powers using the reverse rule of indices, that if you times indices with the same base, you can add the powers. I've done that effectively in reverse because I've got an addition on my power. I can split it up with a multiply with the same base with those two values. Now let's write down what these values are. One's going to be 16 times 4 to the power of k. The next one's going to be 25 times 5 to the power of k. And the next one's going to be 36, lots of 6 to the power of k. Okay, so what I'm now going to do is a really cheeky factorization. Just because 16 appears at the front, I'm going to factorize out 16 from all of my terms and put in the assumption step. I'm effectively going to force the assumption step to appear here because I know that that is divisible by 15. So hopefully the extra bits are going to be divisible by 15 as well. Now, the 4 to the power of k is fine, but what about the 5 to the power of k? At the moment, I've only got 16 lots of this 5 to the power of k, but I'd like to have 25 lots of 5 to the power of k. So I need to now add on an extra 9 lots of 5 to the power of k. And with the 6 to the power of k, I've got 16 lots of 6 to the power of k, but I'd actually like 36 lots of 6 to the power of k. So I need to add on now an extra 20 lots of 6 to the power of k. Now, how is this going to help me? Well, actually, what I can do is I can give a good reason why each of these is divisible by 15. Let's call this part I, let's call this part II, and let's call this part III. Or A, B, and C you could do. Part I is divisible by 15 because it's by the assumption. Assumption divisible by 15. For part 2 is divisible by 15 because it's got a factor of 3 in it and a factor of 5 in it. So by a factor of 3 in 9 and 5 in 5 to the power of k, this is divisible by 15. Is divisible by 15. And moving on to the third part of this summation here, we've got by a factor of 5 in the 20, by a factor of 5 in 20, and 3 in 6 to the power of k. This is divisible by 15. Okay, my pen is really lagging at the moment here. So what I would conclude this part 3 with is, as we have 3 expressions that are divisible by 15, the summation must also be divisible by 15 as well. So I'd put that in that little section there, what I've just said there. As we have three expressions that are divisible by 15, the summation of those expressions will also be divisible by 15. So there we are. We've proven part 3. And now move on to prove. And now move on to conclude in part 4. As we have proven true for n equals 1, and therefore assuming for an odd value k, our theorem works, then for the next odd number, k plus 2, we have shown that our theorem also works. So therefore, by proof by induction, our theorem works for odd integers n. And make sure you clearly state that this only works for odd integers n at the end, rather than just saying it works for all n numbers. So there we are, that's the answer for this question here. Apologies for me not writing it out, my pen is a little bit glitchy, though, and it'll take me forever. So there we are, that's 6 marks for part B. That's 12 marks in total for question 6. Let's now move on to the final question of the paper, question 7.